Hey, YouTubers. Simon Papa Smurf here again. The latest, the Jupiter 2 update number 4. I want to share a couple things with you. Oh, for the fellow that wrote the nasty comment about how I talk too much, well, my video, my rules, like I said, and let's try it your way. See my point? Keep your comments to yourself. Thanks. Let's see. Got a lot of work done on Jupiter 2. Lots of nice detail we're going to go over. If you remember, these segments are so detailed and so small that although it's just this little thing here I've been working on, it's a lot of work, and I'll show you why. Here's our little gyro ball, which will have the lighting effects. Oh, and there's been an upgrade in the project. I'm going to share that with you. In here are the many, many little pieces of the Johnny Lightning B9, Lightning, which is the closest thing to scale I can think of from comparing it to the height of the figures that are scaled for the 18-inch Mobius when I had them put together. It's just about right to convert and light. And I've always wanted to have B9 staring out the viewport or something, and I have to do that on upcoming 12-inch version, which of course I'll have to scratch build them. There is no B9 that small, as far as I know. If anybody knows, please let me know. Anyway, so we'll be going over how I'm going to do that. A couple other doodahs and all. Oh, the new t-shirts, Kit Factory t-shirts. Not saying you'll have to buy one, but most excellent logo. Excellent, excellent. Ooh, titty. Anyways, they're available, although mostly for my clients, when a client receives a kit or an order, they get a free t-shirt. And I thought, hey, that's a nice touch. They're not the cheapies, actually. Standard t-shirts for promotions are $6-$7. These cost me about $15-$16. So I'm not really making any money on it. Boy, are they sweet little, cute little t-shirts. I like them. Let's see, what else? I think I'll cover it about for now. What was it? Somebody was saying something earlier. Let me say, yeah. I'm gonna go back. And there was something. Where is it? I wanted to share with you. I got a message coming from Vinny. I'll show you the message. Maybe he's got something funny to say.
Hey, Papa Smurfy. Papa Smurfy. Smurfy, look.
Shut up.
Hey, I got some news for you. Well, we find the guy who doesn't know likey on the Facebook. YouTube. YouTube, Facebook, what's the difference?
Tucci, I swear, if you no shut up, I kill you.
Bad things happen to him. You're gonna hear about it in the paper. Of course, we weren't there. We was elsewhere. I don't know, I think so. Anyways, he was a pig that wouldn't fly right, and he did the no-likey on the Facebook thing, so I'ma just let you know the, model dude, model guy, whatever. He's sleeping with the fishes. And then, Stanley gotta go get some cement. Talk to you later,
Papa. Alright, here we go. Now, you're gonna hear a whole lot of thumping, because right now the roofers are upstairs working on my roof. The studio is looking like a sieve. And that's because somebody maybe didn't do it as good as they could have the first time. Let's take a look at what we're working on here. This is the wall with the computer display. And I don't know here, let me step back, take a look. Oh, here you go. You kind of see how the clear cubes here have been ambered and a sort of a red amber. Go back in the light here. All these little panels are all the paragraphics. Ooh, does it focus? Does it focus? Yes. You see all these panels have been applied. Mostly colored in. The alcove inside, if you can see here, has been painted silver. and I'm working on the other assemblies. Now the nice thing about this is that when it's rear lit, I will have a pulsating effect on this back wall here. And let's see if I can give you kind of a concept, which will pulse up and down, similar to the cryo tubes. And we'll see how that turns out. Here's what's left of my Paragraphics metal edge parts so far. Must say I really like these, especially since the hole's already perforated, which makes the fiber optic matching very accurate. Here's our gyro ball. Again, I'm stepping behind the screen here to make sure you guys get to see this. Do the hand trick. Learn that from Dave Mintz. Not sure it's working, though. A little fuzzy. But this gyro ball will have the lighting effects. What I did lose was the little center ridge here. And I'll put that back on with either some styrene or some very small wire. And that, of course, goes in here. Ooh. Yes. Okay. Now here's the panels that do the structural for the gyro ball, and they're all ready to go. And you may be asking how you're going to get that through there. Well, I always do an enclave or a cutout from the rear, and that way it gives me a chance to manipulate things so the lighting is just correct. Now let's talk about the B9. And again, stepping behind the camera, make sure I'm doing it right. Here's the Paragraphics figures that are used for the kit. Now, I'm not going to use the figures in this one, but they did give me a darn good idea of scaling the figures. And the roofers just keep plugging away. So what I did do is modify a Johnny Lightning. Now, the height is just about right. If you assemble it, you'll see that by the time you're all done, something like that, with the chest and all that good stuff, he's just about the right height compared to a figure. So I'm not saying it's the right scale or not. I think the Chariot and the Potter 1/24th, I think the J2 may be a tad smaller scale than that. I'm not sure. Maybe a 1/30th, 1/35th, I don't know. I do know the 12-inch is like a 1/42nd or 47th upstairs and 1/52nd downstairs, some kind of mutation. Anyway, so what we'll be doing, tough part being is that the bottom part is die-cast metal. So we'll have to drill that. Ooh, you found a hole. Good job, Mr. Roofer. And we'll be drilling and, of course, lighting from the powering from the bottom. Good thing is this is hollowed out. Now this is going to be tricky. I'm going to have to do some serious drilling because I want to get some fiber optics up into the head. But it can be done. Tricky part, the cutouts on the bottom. These are lit red. And unfortunately they're solid. So I'm going to have to do a little bit of modification there. Other than that, it's possible it can be done. And with my wispy, very tiny fiber optics, I will be able to do it. Let's see what else we got. Let me go over here to the paint table. Show you a part that's currently primed, almost ready to be worked on. What you're seeing there as far as the finished panel of the computer wall, this is a result of a whole lot of paint applications and some hand painting as well. Frankly, these guys here took quite a while, and they have a lacquer finish because, I don't know if you can see, but the decal circuit patterns have been put on there, and so they don't move around or look like a decal. They've been glossed over. And it's very effective. I can't wait to put the pulsating back there. Of course, I'll share that with you. Now, here's that computer wall. And I'm still checking back here to make sure you guys got some light in here. There we go. Notice how it blends really nice. This is a brass etch. And it blends really, really nicely into the overall plastic. And then another cool little part, our little reel-to-reels, will be three-dimensional. And yes, in the instructions it says Uber detailing, have them suckers spinning around. Well, perhaps in a future build where I have a bit more of a budget, then I could get a lot of things animated. I know a guy who's really, really good at those miniature things, and he's a bud, so maybe I can ask him how he did it. I'm sure it's some kind of tiny, teeny motor that can be obtained. And that gives you an eye where we're at for now. Moving along nicely. And I just wanted to update you, as it's been taking quite a while. We are further along than you might think. Like I showed you in the last video,
I had all the segments posted up and show you. You know, there's just a few walls remaining, the cryo tubes, a few other things, and it all starts to go together. But this is coming out particularly well. These brass are going to be silver. Then this insert goes into here. And you can see with the gyro ball inside.
Where are you?
You start to get the general feel of what this is going to look like. All lit up, of course. And that's where we're at for now, kids. If you've enjoyed this little video, it's a little shorter than usual, but the roofer's driving me nuts. And I got a disturbing message from Vinny, but I don't really know what's going on with that. So if there's something that happens after I leave, the editor will put it in the film for you. But doesn't sound good for my guy.
I hate this guy. I hate him so much. Yeah, baby. Yeah, stupid little... Yeah, I'll give him some glasses here. That'll work. Hit my mustache. Yeah, that'd be good. You know, little passer.
Ah, boys and girls. Model guy. Well, we're gonna work on... What the hell is this? We was working on it last time, I think. And then I poked myself in the eye with a popsicle stick, so that didn't go very well there, boys and girls.
What the hell is that music?
Where is it, that cockroach? Hey, cockroach! I dare you not to do the no likey thing on the Facebook thing.
You too, me. Well, Papa Smurfy, shut up. I tell you, I'm going to stab you in the eye. Go! You're still twitching, Tucci. What is this? Give me the other thing. Yo. You suck. Have a nice day. Arrivederci.